Pulling. So the southern state of Kerala will go to polls on 23rd of April. 20 Lok Sabha seats will be going for polling on that particular day. We have with us none other than the Chief Electoral Officer of the state of Kerala, Mr. Tikaram Meena, with us. Sir, welcome to Rajya Sabha Television. Let's begin with the basic facts and figures about the state of Kerala. How many voters do you have? And in terms of the first-time voters, the young voters, what is their percentage and number here in the state of Kerala?
Well, this time we have sizable number of voters as far as the young voters are concerned. Out of 2 crore 61 lakhs total voters, we have got around 5.5 lakhs young voters this time. Okay. In the age group of 18 to 19. Mm-hmm. And this has a further one more striking feature is that this time we have launched a very intensive campaign to enroll the young voters. Mm-hmm. So those who have just crossed 18 years, we have been able to enroll around 3,67,000 voters who have just crossed 18 years.
Okay. I was going through the state and the city also, so I could see, quite an intensive campaign by the Election Commission, huge posters and banners as well, audiovisual publicity as well. In terms of, voter awareness programs, since this is a large number, 5.5 lakh, the young voters and the others as well, the last time polling percentage was somewhere around 77%, if I'm not wrong, in 2014. Yes. So what's the target this time around for the Election Commission? And, what all has been done in terms of making voters aware about their right to vote?
Well, Election Commission have launched a very innovative scheme called SWEEP, that is Systematic Voters Education and Enrollment Program. And as part of that, we have come out with a lot of creative posters, lot of this street plays, and we have come out with a very beautiful, election song this time, which has caught the attention of all the sections of the society, particularly the youngsters. Mm-hmm. In the rural areas also, we have gone deep into the rural areas, because this time Election Commission has given the direction to constitute these electoral literacy clubs. Mm-hmm. In all the schools, colleges, in the universities. We have constituted around 1,000 electoral literacy clubs in the whole state. Mm-hmm. And in all these colleges and universities, one professor is nominated as an ambassador. Okay. So they hold a lot of awareness campaign, lot of awareness activities, okay. Seminars, workshops, and they discuss a lot of issues related with the voter participation and awareness. Apart from that, we have identified 2 major icons this time. Mm-hmm. One of them is our famous singer Kesh Chitra, who has sung this theme song for Kerala mm-hmm. elections, as well as the Metro Man Mr. Sridharan. Okay. So we have come out with their posters and their slogans, as well as we have taken some video spots also, which is being shown in the social media as well as the electronic media, appealing the voters to come out in a large number and vote. So our target is that last time it was 77%. At least we should touch 90% this time.
Okay. That's a big target, and hoping that with all this intensive campaign it will be achieved. In terms of conducting a free and fair poll, let's go with again facts and figures. How many polling stations are there? What are the security arrangements? And ensuring that the use of money is curbed and all other illegal practices which are violation of MCC, they're being taken care of. What are various steps?
Well, as far as Kerala is concerned, Kerala do not have any expenditure sensitive constituency. The influence of money is not comparatively very less here. Mm-hmm. However, as you know, Kerala is a very beautiful state. There are some hilly areas, there are hilly tracts like Idukki and Wayanad, etc., where earlier there were some booths which were not accessible. But right now, out of 25,970 polling booths, almost 100% are well connected. Mm-hmm. So as such, we don't have any problem to send the materials, and polling parties will be able to reach to any polling station in a single day. As you asked about the security arrangements, we have made very extensive security arrangement this time. We have got 57 number of companies of paramilitary forces, and they will be mostly deployed in the areas which are having little bit threat of the Maoist activities. Okay. That is Wayanad, Malappuram, Kalikat and Kannur. These are the sensitive areas where we have identified a lot of polling booths, around more than 1,000 polling booths as sensitive, critical and vulnerable.
Okay.
And apart from the paramilitary forces, we will be deploying the, we will be doing the webcasting also. And under the supervision of the observer, mm-hmm. there will be micro observers deployed in these areas, which are very critical mm-hmm. and sensitive.
Okay, so clearly as explained by the Chief Electoral Officer of Kerala, Mr. Tikaram Meena, this is going to be a very interesting election in Kerala. All steps have been taken by the Election Commission to ensure that it is a free and fair poll and everybody gets to cast their vote. We from Rajya Sabha TV once again appeal to you, the people of Kerala, the voters, to come out and cast your vote, exercise your franchise on 23rd of April. With camera person Vijay Singh, this is Vishal Dahiya in Trivandrum for Rajya Sabha TV.